The accommodations?
No, no. They appear quite interesting.
Cells are below. This is the common room for those who wait.
How long do they wait?
Oh, some an hour, some a lifetime.
Do they all await the Inquisition?
Oh, no. These are merely thieves and murderers. If you need anything, just shout, if you're able.
What did he mean by that?
Calm yourself. There is a remedy for everything but death.
That would be the very one we need.
Good morning, gentlemen, ladies. I regret being thrust upon you in this manner, and I hope you shall not find my company objectionable. In any case, I trust I shall not be among you very long. Hey. The Inquisition has planned...
Noise, trouble, fights. Kill each other if you must, but for God's sake, do it quietly. Now then, who are you?
Cervantes. Don Miguel de Cervantes.
Oh, a gentleman.
It has never saved me from going to bed hungry.
And what's that?
My servant. May I have the honor?
They call me the governor. What's your game?
My game?
Your specialty, man. Cut purse, highway.
Oh, nothing so interesting. I am a poet.
They are putting man in prison for that?
No, no, not for that.
Too bad.
Well, let's get on with the trial.
Yeah, come on. Excuse me, sir. What trial?
Yours, of course.
But what have I done?
Oh, we'll think of something.
You don't seem to understand. I'll only be here a few hours, and then the Inquisition will come, and everything will be set.
My dear sir, no one enters or leaves this prison without being tried by his fellow prisoners.
And if I'm found guilty?
Oh, you will be.
What sort of a sentence?
Well, we generally fine a prisoner all his possessions.
All of them?
It's not practical to take more.
One moment. These things are my livelihood.
I thought you said you were a poet.
Of the theater.
False.
Costumes and properties. You see, actually, I'm a playwright and an actor. So, of course, these two things couldn't be of any
use. Master!
No, please, not that. Please.
Heavy? Valuable?
Only to me.
We might let you ransom it.
I have no money.
Oh, unfortunate.
What is it?
Paper?
It is a manuscript.
Ah, worthless.
Wait! You spoke of a trial. By your own word, I must be given a trial.
Oh, very well. I hereby declare this court in session. All right. What are you here for?
I am to appear before the Inquisition.
Heresy?
Not exactly. You see, I have been employed by the government as a tax collector.
Poet. Actor?
Actor.
Tax collector?
A temporary thing, to keep us from starvation.
How does a tax collector get in trouble with the Inquisition?
I made an assessment against the monastery of La Merced. When they refused to pay, I issued a lien on the property.
You did what?
He foreclosed on a church!
Wait a minute, why are you here?
Someone had to take the notice on a church door.
You have empty rooms in there.
The law says, treat everyone equally. We only obey the law.
Cover, if you don't mind, I should like to prosecute this case.
Why?
Well, let us say, I dislike stupidity, especially when it masquerades as virtue. Miguel de Cervantes, I charge you with being an idealist, a bad poet, and an honest man. How plead you?
Guilty.
Yes!
Your Excellency! Don Miguel! What about my defense?
You just pleaded guilty.
Since I have admitted of guilt, isn't the court required to hear me out?
For what purpose?
The jury may choose to be lenient.
Governor, he's flying to gain time.
Do you have a scarcity of that?
Do we have any urgent appointment?
It is true. I am guilty of these charges. An idealist. Well, I've never had the courage to believe in nothing. A bad poet, that comes more painfully. Still, I would be very willing to...
Let's hear your defense.
Your Excellency, if you have no objection, I should like to present it in the manner I know best. in the form of an entertainment.
Entertainment.
At worst, it may beguile your time. And if any of you should care to enter in...
Governor, I should like to protest.
No. Let's hear him out.
Then, may I set the stage? I shall impersonate a man. Come, enter into my imagination and see him. His name, Alonso Quijana, a country squire, no longer young. Bony and hollow-faced, eyes that burn with the fire of inner vision. Being retired, he has much time for books. He studies them from morn to night, and often through the night as well. And all he reads oppresses him, fills him with indignation at man's murderous way toward man. He broods and broods and broods. And finally, from so much brooding, his brains dry up. He lays down the melancholy burden of sanity and conceives the strangest project ever imagined, to become a knight-errant and sally forth into the world to right all wrongs. No longer shall he be plain Alonso Quijana, but a dauntless knight known as Don Quichotte de la Mancha.
Hear me now, thou bleak and unbearable world, thou at base and in force as can be. And the night with its banners all brave thee unfurled, now hurl down its gauntlet for thee. I am I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha, mightiest than he calls and I call. And the wild winds of fortune will carry me onward, with us so ever
chickens cheap.
Like beauty, my friend. 'Tis all in the eyes of the beholder. Only wait, and thou shalt see amazing sights.
What kind?
Why, knights, nations, warlocks, wizards, a cavalcade of vast, unending armies.
Ooh, they sound dangerous.
They are dangerous. But wonder on me who leads them. And he will be most dangerous of all.
Well, who is it?
Who? The great enchanter. Beware him, Sancho, for his thoughts are cold, and his spirit shriveled, and wherever he walks, the earth is blighted. Oh, but one day, I'm going to meet him face to face, and on that day,
I wouldn't get upset about that, Your Grace.
As I always say, have patience and shuffle the cards.
Do you never run out of proverbs?
No. I was born with a belly full of
What is it?
How long since we sallied forth?
About 2 minutes.
So soon shall I engage in brave, unequal combat.
Combat? Where?
Canst not see, there below, a monstrous giant of infamous repute.
What giant?
It is a dark and dreaded ogre by the name of Metagoga. I can tell him by the four great arms whirling on his back.
It's a windmill!
Oh, feckless giant standing there! Avast, avant! On guard, beware!
Didn't I tell you? Didn't I say, Your Grace? It's a windmill!
The work of my enemy!
The enchanter?
At the last moment, he was able to transform that giant into a windmill. Sancho!
What, Your Grace?
It comes to me.
What?
How he was able to upset me. It is, because I've never properly been dubbed a knight.
Oh, that's no problem. Just tell me how it's done, and I shall be glad to take care of this dubbing.
Dubbing? Thank you, my friend, but it may only be done by another knight.
That's a problem. I have never seen another knight.
The lord of some castle would do, or a king, or even a duke.
Very well, Your Grace. As we go on, I shall keep an eye out for any
king. Aha!
Now what?
The very place.
Where?
There.
If Your Grace would just give me a hint.
There in the distance. A castle.
Castle?
Brook bound amidst the crags.
Crags?
And the banners. Ah, the brave banners flaunting in the wind.
Anything on them?
I see a cat crouching on a field of tawny. And beneath it. The inscription, meow. Undoubtedly the insignia of some great lord.
Oh, that's fine, Your Grace. Maybe this is the very place where you can get yourself dropped.
Dub, blow thy bugle, that a dwarf may mount the battlements and announce our coming.
But, I don't see your castle. I do see something. Maybe it's an inn.
Ha! An inn.
We'd better pass it by, Your Grace, because those roadside places are full of rough men and women.
Come, come, we shall ride straight to the drawbridge of your own castle, and there thy vision may improve. And here is an example of how, to the untrained eye, one thing may seem to be another. To Sancho, an inn. To Quichotte, a castle. To someone else, whatever his mind may make of it. But for the sake of argument, let us grant Sancho his vision, an inn. A kindly innkeeper, his less kindly wife, and their idiot daughter, Fermina. Rough men, muleteers, 15 miles on the road today. Rough women, in most particular, a woman called Aldonza! Oh! Why? Aldonza! Oh! Why? Aldonza! Oh! Why? Aldonza!
You want it on the table or over your lousy head? Mother, I brought you something.
Keep it till it grows up. Little dogs have big ideas.
Hey, tonight I'm on.
Payment in advance.
Now go on, sweetheart. Come here.
Talk with your mouth, not your hands.
I've got a nice bed of hay in the stable.
Good. Eat it.
You would refuse, Pedro?
Try me.
My mules are not as stubborn.
Try me. Make love to your mule.
I come for love. I come for love. I come to a mouth for love.
Just help him stable your animals. gentle knights. Chatelaine, if there be any among you that require assistance, you have but to speak, and my good right arm is at your service. Whether it be a princess held for ransom, or an army besieged and awaiting rescue, or Miriam.
Dear God, it is she. Sweet lady, fair virgin.
I dare not gaze full upon thy countenance, lest I be blinded by beauty. But I implore thee, speak once thy name.
Aldonza.
My lady jests.
Aldonza.
The name of a kitchen scullion, or mayhap, my lady's serving maid.
I told you my name. No, get out of my room.
Let my lady think to put me to a test. Ah, sweet sovereign of my captive heart, I shall not fail thee, for I know I have dreamed thee too long, never seen thee or touched thee, but known thee with all of my heart. Half a prayer, half a song, thou hast always been with me, though we have been always apart. Dulcinea! Mancha, but the simple women folk of a country squire known as Alonso Quijana. Imagine their shock as news of the master's madness reaches them. To his niece, Antonia, who is worried about its effect on her forthcoming marriage. To his
housekeeper of many years, who is worried about even darker matters. To the local padre, who has known Alonso all his life. And shortly, there will enter a character whose philosophy, I think, will appeal enormously to you. Alonso's niece and his housekeeper hurry to the neighborhood church. Sancho, may we have a church, please? Anguished by this terrible situation, and not unaware of what the neighbors may think, they seek help and advice from the local padre. The padre. But in spite of all the trouble which the squire's madness may bring down upon their heads, you may be sure they're only thinking of him. Carrasco. Bachelor of Science, graduate of the University of Salamanca, a man who carries his own self-importance as though afraid of breaking it.
Listen,
I had forgotten that family quarrels have a way of getting out of hand. With so much at stake in the game, let us rearrange the pieces. The queen, clever. The castle, formidable. The bishop, charmingly diagonal. And now, the problem of the knight.
Sanson,
have you heard?
On my way here, I was informed by at least 10 people. My dear, your uncle is the laughing stock of the entire neighborhood. Padre, what do you know of this?
Only that the good Signor Quijana has been carried away by his imagination.
Signor Quijana has lost his mind and is suffering from delusions.
Is there a difference?
Exactitude of meaning. I beg to remind you, Padre, that I am a doctor.
Please don't argue. We must do something about him.
I'm a little more concerned about us.
What do you mean, us?
Our marriage, my dear. There is a certain embarrassment at having a madman in the family. In the eyes of others.
Oh, come, doctor.
I do not relish claiming a lunatic as uncle.
The innocent must pay for the sins of the guilty.
Guilty of what? A gentle delusion.
How do you know it is gentle? By this time, who knows what violence he has committed? He was armed
with sword and lance.
Sanson, I talk for so much for us. For you, really. Everything was to be for you. My uncle's house, his lance.
True, doctor. In time, they would all be yours. After all, if one is to serve science, one must have the means.
Are you priest or pawnbroker?
What I meant was consider the challenge.
Challenge?
Think what cleverness it would take to wean this man from madness, to turn him from his course, and persuade him to return home.
That is a challenge.
Impossible.
He can't have gotten far.
No more than a day's journey.
Get ready, padre. We shall go after him. But as we go, there is one thing that I want the world to know.
I feel with pain that once again we now will hear a very often heard refrain.
He's only thinking of him. My body, it's well known, there is not one selfish bone.
They're only thinking of him.
Let us return now to the inn. Now then, as everybody knows, it is imperative that each knight shall have a lady. For a knight without a lady is like a body without a soul. To whom would he dedicate his conquests? What visions sustain him when he sallies forth to do battles with ogres and with giants? Don Quixote, having discovered his lady, sends his faithful squire to her with a missive. That's a letter.
Missive. What's a missive?
A sort of a letter. My master warned me to give it only into your hand.
Let's see it. I can't read.
Neither can I. But my master, foreseeing such a possibility, recited it to me so I could commit it to heart.
What made him think I couldn't read?
Well, as he explained it, noble women are so busy with their needlework.
Needlework?
Embroidering banners for the knights. He said they had no time for study.
What's it saying?
Most lovely sovereign and high-born lady, the heart of this thy vessel knight
faints for thy favor. O fairest of the fair, purest of the pure, incomparable Dulcinea.
That again? My name is Aldonza.
My master calls you Dulcinea.
Why?
I don't know. But I can tell you from experience that all knights have their own language for everything, and it is better for you not to ask any questions because it only gets you into trouble. I beg thee grant that I may kiss the nethermost hem of thy garment.
Kiss my what?
If you keep interrupting me, the whole thing will be gone upon my head.
Well, what does he want?
That's what I'm getting to. And send to me a token of thy fair esteem, that I may carry as my standard and go battle.
What kind of a token?
He says, generally it's a silken scarf.
Your master's a crack brain.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Well, as they say, one madman makes 100, but love makes 1,000.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
You're crazy too. Well, what are you waiting for?
The token.
All right. I'll give him a token. Here.
But my lady.
Don't you, my lady, me too, or I'll crack you like an egg. Wait a minute. Come here. Sit. Sit. Tell me, why do you follow him?
Oh, that's easy to explain.
I'm
telling you, I...
Why?
I like him. I really like him. Tear out my fingernails one by one. I like him. I don't have a very good. Since I've been with him, coconuts have been in season. But there's nothing I can do. Chop me up for onion stew. Still I yell to the sky, though I can tell you why, that I like
him. It doesn't make any sense.
That's because you're not a squire.
All right. You're a squire.
Yep.
How does a squire squire?
Well, you see, I ride behind him, and he fights, and then I pick him up off the ground.
But what do you get out of it?
Me? Plenty. I've gotten so much.
You've gotten nothing! So why do you do it?
I like him. I really like him. Pluck me naked as a scalded chicken. I like him. Don't ask me for why or wherefore, 'cause I don't have a single good. But you my nose, make a giblet of my toes, make me freeze, make me fry, make me sigh, make me cry, still I yell to the sky, though I can't tell you why, that I like him.
Not good enough? Just like people, you always want what the other one's got. It's the same as I get, maybe even better. A fine pair, just as crazy as your man's. Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. You've got no choice. But who can figure him out? Who reads? sons of whores!
Most lovely sovereign young and high-born lady.
Let her come tonight. A stupid joke!
Oh, yeah, then why so hot about it?
Has he touched your heart?
Nobody touches my heart.
All these fine words?
Fine words! He's a man, isn't he? So he wants what every other man wants.
Hold on, sir. Now?
Lady. When I'm through in the kitchen.
I confess I shall not know what to say to him.
In that case, leave it to me.
But he may not even know us.
I'm prepared for that, but then you see, should he...
Who is it? Cry of help of Don Quichotte de la Mancha. Is there a castle beleaguered by giants? A king who lies under enchantment? Or an army besieged and awaiting rescue?
Why? What is this? My friends!
You know us.
Should a man not know his own friends, Dr. Carrasco? Padre Pires.
Signor Quijana.
I should prefer that you address me properly. I am Don Quixote, knight errant of La Mancha.
Signor Quijana.
Don Quixote.
There are no giants, no kings under enchantment, no chivalry, no knights. There have been no knights for 300 years.
So learned, yet so misinformed.
These are facts.
Facts are the enemy of truth.
Your Grace, well, did she receive thee?
Yes.
Oh, most fortunate of squires. The token. What of the token? Oh, fear gossamer. Oh, forgive me, my friends. I'm overcome.
It's from his lady.
So, there is a woman.
A lady. The lady Calcinea. Her beauty is more than human.
Her quality, perfection.
She is the very meaning of woman, and all meaning woman has to man.
To each his Dulcinea.
Oh, I am a barber, I'm righteous, I'm very well.
Is that the one
with my razor and my leeches, I can all measure my pay. Though you
oh, change but see what he wears upon his
you
head.
You'll meet me soon, I know.
And he always I'm sure
the Lord collects in barbers, and he makes his barbers wrong. If I slip when I am shaving you, I cut you to the quick. You can use me as a doctor, cause I also heal the sick.
Sick! By the death of Saint Anthony, I could swear I see a knight in full armor.
That's ridiculous. There aren't any knights!
Here for your worship. I'm wrong. I thought I'd be touched by the sword.
Thou wilt be touched by far worse if thou dost not speedily hand over that golden helmet.
What, where? But this is my shaving basin.
Ha! Shaving basin?
Your Grace, it does look like a shaving basin.
Of course. You see, I am a barber. Barber. I ply my trade from village to village, and I was wearing this on my head to ward off the rays of the sun. So, that's how you hide your
maiden. Silence! Know thou what that really is? A golden helmet of Mambrino. When worn by one of noble heart, it renders him invulnerable to all wounds. This begotten name, where didst thou steal it?
I didn't steal it.
Hand it over.
But it cost me half a crown.
Hand it over, all right.
No.
Your Grace, it is worth a half a crown.
Fool!
Oh, fool and a fowl.
can hear the cuckoo singing in the cuckoo berry tree. If he says that that's a helmet, I suggest that you agree. But you find it is not gold, I will not make him bold and brave. Well, at least he'll find it useful if he ever needs a shave.
Yes, that's the list.
Therefore, I would beg a boon of thee.
Anything within reason.
Tonight, I would hold vigil in the chapel of thy castle. And at dawn, receive from thy hand the ennobling stroke of knighthood.
There's one small difficulty.
A difficulty?
No chapel.
What?
That is to say, it's being repaired. But... if you wouldn't mind holding your vigil someplace else.
Here, in the courtyard, under the stars.
Fine. At sunrise, you'll be dubbed a knight.
I thank thee.
And now will you have some supper?
Supper before a vigil. Nay, my lord, on this night, I must fast and compose my spirit.
There goes either the wisest madman or the maddest wise man in the world.
He is mad.
In any case, we have failed.
Not necessarily. We know the sickness. Now to find the cure.
The cure? May it not be worse than the disease.
That he alone can name, to each a secret hiding place, where he can find a haunting face to light his secret flame. With his Dulcinea beside him so to stand, a man can do quite anything, I'll fly the bird upon the wing of moonlight in his hand. Yet if you build your life on dreams, it's prudent to recall a man with moonlight in his hand has nothing there. Keep him from despair.
Don Quichotte, with measured tread and lofty expression, held vigil in the courtyard of a mighty castle.
O maker of empty boasts, and this of all knights, to give way to vanity.
Nay, Don Quichotte, take a deep breath of life and consider how it should be lived. Call nothing thy own except thy soul. Love not what thou art, but only what thou may become. Do not pursue pleasure, for thou may have the misfortune to overtake it. Look always forward. In last year's nests there are no birds this year. Be just to all men. Be courteous to all women. Live in the vision of that one for whom great deeds are done, she that is called Dulcinea.
Why do you call me that?
Milady.
Get up from there. Get up. Why do you call me by that name?
Because it is thine.
My name is Aldonza.
I know thee, lady.
My name is Aldonza, and I think you know me not.
All my years I have known thee. Thy virtue, thy nobility of spirit.
Take another look.
I have already seen thee in my heart.
Your heart doesn't know much about women.
It knows all, my lady. A woman is the very soul of man, the radiance that lights his way. A woman is glory.
What do you want of me?
Nothing?
Liar!
I deserve the rebuke. I ask of my lady.
Now we get to it.
That I may be allowed to serve her. That I may hold her in my heart. That I may dedicate each victory and call upon her in defeat. And if at last I give my life, I give it in the sacred name of Dulcinea.
I must go. Pedro's waiting. Why do you do these things?
What things, milady?
These ridiculous, the things you do.
I hope to add some measure of grace to the world.
The world's a dung heap, and we are maggots that crawl on it.
Milady knows better in her heart.
What's in my heart will get me halfway to hell. But you, Señor Don Quixote, you're going to take such a beating.
Whether I win or lose does not matter.
What does?
Only that I follow the quest.
That's for your quest. What does it mean? Quest?
It is the mission of each true knight, his duty. Nay, his privilege.
To dream the impossible dream. To fight the unbeatable foe. Not go to
right, the unrightable wrong. To love pure and taste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary.
Peaceable man, please. Sir Knight, I don't want to be inhospitable, but I must ask you to leave as soon as you're able.
I am sorry to have offended the dignity of my castle, and I shall depart with daylight. But first, I must remind thee of thy promise.
My promise?
True, it is not yet dawn. I kept vigil and proven myself in combat. Therefore, I beg thou, dub me knight.
Oh, certainly I can do that. Let's get it over with.
Sancho, will be good enough to fetch my sword and my golden helmet. Milady, I cannot tell thee how joyful I am. This ceremony should take place in thy presence.
Be careful now.
It is a solemn moment which seals my vocation.
Are you ready?
I am.
Then kneel.
Don Quichotte de la Mancha, I hereby dub thee knight.
Your lordship.
What's the matter? Didn't I do it right?
If your lordship could make some mention of the deeds I performed to earn this honor.
Yes. Certainly, certainly.
Don Quixote de la Mancha, having proven thyself this day in glorious battle, and by my authority as lord of this castle, I hereby dub thee knight.
Your lordship.
Something else?
It is customary to grant the new knight an added name. If your lordship could devise such a name for me.
Hail, knight of the woeful countenance, knight of the woeful countenance. Wherever you go, people will know of the glorious deeds of the knight of the woeful countenance. Farewell and good cheer, O my brave cavalier, ride onward to glorious strife. I swear when you're gone, I'll remember you well for all of the rest of my life. Hail, knight of the woeful countenance, knight of the woeful countenance. Wherever you go, face to the foe, they will quail at the sight of the knight of the woeful countenance. Oh, valorous knight, go and fight for the right, and battle all villains that be. But oh, when you do, what will happen to you? Thank God I won't be there to see.
To their wounds.
What?
Nobility demands.
It does?
Yes, my lady. Therefore I shall go, and I shall take
no,
these.
No, you won't. I'll take it. I'll minister.
But
there were my enemies too.
Oh, blessed one. Oh, blessed one.
Your Grace, now let's get you to bed. You must be tired.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm going to minister to your wounds.
You're going to what?
Nobility demands. Turn over your boxy goat!
Ha ha!
Ah, Sancho, how I do envy my enemies. Envy? To think they know the healing touch of my lady Dulcinea. Let this be proved to you, Sancho. Nobility triumphs. Virtue always prevails. Now, in the moment of victory, do I confer my knighthood and my oath. For all my life, this I do swear.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe.
That sound of the men of the Inquisition. What does it mean?
They're coming to fetch someone. They haul him off. Put the question to him.
Next thing he knows, he's burning.
Are they coming for me?
Very possibly. What, Cervantes? Are you afraid? Where's your courage? Is that in your imagination too? No escape, Cervantes. This is happening. Not to you, brave man of La Mancha, but to you. Quick, Cervantes, call upon him. Let him shield you. Let him save you if he can from that.
Great wide place.
A desert? Wasteland?
Which apparently grows lunatics.
I would say rather men of illusion.
Much the same. Why are you poets so fascinated with madmen?
I suppose we have much in common.
You both turn your backs on life.
We both select from life what pleases us.
A man must come to terms with life as it is.
My friend, I have lived almost 50 years, and I have seen life as it is. Pain, misery, hunger, cruelty beyond belief. I've heard the singing from taverns and the moans of bundles of filth on the streets. I've been a soldier and see my comrades fall in battle or die more slowly under the lash in Africa. I've held him in my arms at the final moment. These were men who saw life as it is, yet they died despairing. No glory, no gallant last words. Only their eyes, filled with confusion, whimpering the question why. I do not think they asked why they were dying, but why they had lived. When life itself seems lunatic, who knows where madness lies? Too much sanity may be madness. To see treasure where there is only trash. To be practical may be madness. And maddest of all, to see life as it is, and not as it should be. I am my Don Quichotte.
I don't understand.
What, my friend?
Why you are so cheerful? First you find your lady and then you lose her.
are never lost.
Well, she ran off with those mule drivers.
But undoubtedly with some high purpose.
High purpose? With those low characters?
Sancho, Sancho.
Always that eye sees evil in preference to good.
There is no use blaming my eye. It doesn't make the world, it only sees it. Anyway, there is something my eyes is clearly enough. Gypsies, Moors, let's make a wide track around them, Your Grace, because they're a scurvy lot. Your Grace can't deny that.
Well, thou hast fallen into the trap of thy pleasant mind again. Have I not taught thee that appearance is not reality?
You mean they are not thieves and murderers?
Never condemn before thou knowest.
A young innocent approaches.
Charming, utterly charming.
But she is a trollop and he is nothing
but... Have done, Sancho, with these foul suspicions. Dost not understand their language?
No.
These two are brother and sister. Offspring of the noble African lord, Sidi Ben Mali.
Brother and sister.
Sweet maiden, what wilt thou?
I think I know what she wilt.
She wishes me to feel the beating of her heart, and such is her innocence that she doesn't even know where it is,
or even how many she has.
Much as I surmised.
What did he say?
It seems the noble African lord of Sidi Ben Mali has been taken captive, and even now lies in durance vile, deep down in a dungeon. While these, his faithful family and retainers, travel the countryside in hope of raising a ransom. Observe, Sancho, the quaint customs of these Africans. In his charming manner, they ask that I make some contribution to their cause.
Your Grace, don't do it!
I would ignore a fellow knight in jeopardy. Here, sweet maiden, with all my heart. Sancho, shame on thee for a reluctant Christian. Shame on thee for a parsimonious wretch. Shame on thee for a small-hearted peasant. Shame on thee, multiple shame. Ah, Sancho, I knew it. I knew it. I knew thy heart was good.
Wonderful, charming girl. Oh, wonderful.
Your Grace, the horses. The horses are gone, Your Grace.
The horses?
We can't do anything without the horses.
But they were here.
They are gone.
This castle has shut down for renovations.
thou wouldst deny
sanctuary?
I hate and to a knight, dropped by thy own hand.
But I admit it doesn't seem right.
Not by any rule of chivalry.
More muleteers?
Oh, no. Gypsies, Moors. They stole our money.
Have done, Sancho.
They stole our animals.
Must thou harp on it?
They stole everything we had.
Can't you declare a truce?
And allow wickedness to flourish.
I'm afraid wickedness wears very thick armor.
And for that, wouldst thou have me stop crying? Nay, let a man be overthrown 10,000 times, still he must rise up and again do battle. The great enchanter may confuse the outcome, but the effort remains sublime.
Lies!
Milady!
Madness and lies!
Constanza, what happened?
Ask him!
Maria!
I shall
Maria!
Punish them with this crime.
Crime? You know, the worst crime of all, being bored. For that you get punished your whole life.
Dulcinea!
Enough of that! Get yourself to a madhouse. Rave about nobility where no one can hear.
Lady!
I'm not your lady! I'm not any kind of a lady! I was born in a ditch by a mother who left me there, naked and cold and too hungry to cry. I never blamed her, I'm sure she left hoping that I'd had the good sense to die. Then of course there's my father, I'm told that young ladies can find all the fathers with maidenly pride. Mine was on regiment here for an hour. I can't even tell you which side. So of course I became as befitted my delicate world, the most casual bride of the murdering scum of the earth.
And still, oh my lady!
Still he torments me! How should I be a lady? For a lady as modest and maidenly airs and a virtue I somehow suspect that I lack. It's hard to remember those maidenly airs. In a stable laid flat on your bed! Won't you look at me? Look at me! God, won't you look at me? Look at the kitchen slut reeking of sweat! Born on a dunghy, die on a dunghy! The strumpet when use and forget! If you feel that you see me not quite at my virginal best, cross my palm with a coin, and I willingly show you the rest!
Never deny that, Dulcinea!
Take the clouds from your eyes and see me as I really am! You have shown me the sky, but what good is the sky to a creature who never do better than crawl? Of all the cruel bastards who fettered and fettered me, you are the cruelest of all! Can't you see what your gentle insanities do to me? Rob me of anger and give me despair. Blows and abuse, I can take and give back again. Tenderness, I cannot bear. So please torture me now with your sweet Dulcinea no more. I'm no one. I'm nothing. I'm only Aldonza, the whore.
Not a forever, not my lady Dulcinea.
No!
Thank you. calls himself Don Quixote de la Mancha. If there is, and he is not afraid to look on me, let him stand forth.
I am Don Quixote, knight of the woeful countenance.
Now hear me, you charlatan. You are no knight, but a foolish pretender. Your pretense is a child's mockery, and your principles dirt beneath my feet.
Oh, false knight, discourteous. For I chastise thee, tell me thy name.
You shall hear it in due course.
Then say why thou seekest me out.
You call upon me, Don Quixote. You reviled and threatened me.
The great enchanter! Beware of thy feet, the gauge of battle!
No, no, master, no!
On what terms do we fight?
Choose thine own.
Very well. If you are beaten, your freedom is forfeit, and you must obey my every command. And your conditions?
If thou art still alive, thou shalt kneel and beg mercy of my lady Dulcinea.
Where is this lady?
There she stands.
Your lady is an alley cat.
Monster! Defend thyself!
Hold! Don Quixote, you ask my name? Now I shall tell it. I am called the Knight of the Mirror. Look, Don Quixote, look in the mirror of reality and behold things as they truly are. Look, Don Quixote, what do you see? A gallant knight? No, nothing but an aging fool. Look! Don Quixote, do you see him? A madman dressed for a masquerade. Look! Don Quixote, see him as he truly is. See the clown. Drown, Don Quixote, drown in the mirror.
Your Grace.
Forgive me, Signor Quijana. It was the only way.
Cervantes, Cervantes, prepare to be summoned.
By whom?
The judges of the Inquisition.
Captain, how soon?
Soon.
But not yet.
Not yet. You'll have time to finish the story.
Yes. But the story is finished.
What?
At least, so far as I know it.
I don't think I like this ending.
No, me neither. I don't think the jury likes it either.
No.
Miguel de Cervantes, I'm afraid you failed. It is a judgment.
Wait! If I could have a little more time.
I will grant it, but the Inquisition is.
A few moments only. Let me improvise.
Thank you.
Thorsteinsson, can you do nothing?
I'm afraid there'll be more need of my services than his. Where is he, I wonder? In what dark cavern of the mind?
According to medical science.
Doctor, please.
Don't you think I did right?
Yes, that's the contradiction.
You again?
To tell him to go away.
What harm can he do?
Yes, it's all been done.
Your Reverence, may I speak to him?
I'm afraid he won't hear you.
Well, then I won't say very much.
And no mention of knight-errantry.
Of course not. Would I speak about the rope in the house of the hanged?
Excuse me, Your Grace.
Your Grace.
Only few words to lighten his heart.
A little gossip, a little chat, a little idle talk of this and that. I'll tell him all the troubles I have had, and since he doesn't hear, at least he won't be bad. When I first got home, my wife Teresa beat me, but the blows fell very lightly on my back. She kept missing every other stroke and crying from the heart that while I was gone, she'd gone and lost her neck. Of course, I hit her back, Your Grace. But you know, she is a lot harder than I am. And do you know what they say? Whether the stone hits the pitcher or the pitcher hits the stone, it's gonna be bad for the pitcher. So I have gotten bruises from all the way down here and all the way. A little gossip, a little chat, a little idle talk of this and that. If no one listens, then it's just as well. At least I won't get caught in any lies I tell. Oh, I haven't fought a windmill in a fortnight, and the humble just get duller every day. Why, when I must leap a dragon with this fiery twinkle wagon, Mr. Sancho, won't you please come out and play?
Enough!
Why? What did I do?
I warned you.
I didn't do anything. I was just trying to speak to him. I haven't
my
seen...
My friend.
Your Grace, did you say something?
You're a fat little bag. This proverb.
Yes, Your Grace.
My dear. Good morning, Padre. Or is it evening?
Alonso.
How do you feel, sir?
Not well, my friend.
Can you speak your name?
Should a man not know his own name?
If you might say it.
Alonso Quijana.
Thank you.
Padre.
Yes, here beside you.
I would like to make a will.
Of course.
Uncle.
My dear, when I close my eyes, I see a pale horse. He beckons me mount.
Oh, Uncle, you'll get well.
Why should a man get well when he is dying? It would be such a waste of good health. Come closer, friends. In my illness, I dreamed so strangely. Oh, such dreams. Why, I thought that I was. I dare not tell you, lest you think me mad.
Put it from your mind.
They are gone, my dear. Nor do I know what they meant. Padre.
Speak, my friend, and I shall write.
I, Alonso Quijana, with one foot in the stirrup and the agony of death already upon me.
Don't admit anyone.
Do hereby make the following disposition of my estate. The Belka bequeath to my beloved niece, Antonia Quijana, with the exception of certain personal bequests which are...
Get out!
Left from the inn.
Oh, I tried to stop her, but she frightened me. Don't tear your eyes out.
Get out of here.
And if you touch me again, by God.
Get out of here.
Not before I see you.
I'm warning you. Go quietly, or
Let be.
Señor Quijana.
In my house, there will be courtesy. Come closer, girl. Now then, what is it you want?
Don't you know me?
Should I?
I'm Aldonza.
I'm sorry. I do not recall anyone of that name.
He knows.
Yes, it was then.
Please, my lord.
Why do you call me my lord? I'm not a lord.
You are my lord, Don Quichotte.
Don Quichotte. You must forgive me. I have been ill and I'm confused by shadows. It is possible I knew you once, but I do not remember.
This way. Come on.
Please, try to remember.
Is it so important?
Everything. My whole life. You spoke to me and everything was different.
I spoke to you.
And you looked at me. And you called me by another name.
Thank you.
profundis clamo a te.
Don Quixote is not dead. Believe, Sancho. Believe.
Aldonza.
My name is Dulcinea.
Domine.
Of the Holy Office of the Inquisition, by reason of certain offences committed against His Majesty's most Catholic Church, the following is summoned to give answer and submit his person for purification, if it be so ordered, Don Miguel de Cervantes.
A popular defendant I am, being summoned by one court before I've quite finished with the other. Well, what says the jury?
I think I know what this contains. The history of your mad knight. Plead as well there as you have here, and you may not burn.
I have no intention of burning. Shall we go, old friend?
Cervantes, I think Don Quixote is brother to Don Miguel.
God help us. We are both men of La Mancha.